वेलकम टू केमिस्ट्री क्लासेस बाय विजय कुमार सेठी। वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट यूनिट वन ऑफ केमिस्ट्री क्लास 11th, सम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ केमिस्ट्री। एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट परसेंटेज कंपोजिशन, एम्पिरिकल फॉर्मूला एंड मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्मूला। फर्स्ट कम टू द परसेंटेज कंपोजिशन। परसेंटेज कंपोजिशन इज द टर्म यूज्ड टू डिस्क्राइब द परसेंट बाय मास ऑफ ईच एलिमेंट इन ए कंपाउंड। It is found using the molar mass values for both the elements in the compound and the compound itself. Percentage composition of a compound is a ratio of an amount of each element to the total amount of individual elements in a compound, which is then multiplied with 100. We can use this formula: mass percent of an element is equal to mass of that element in the compound divided by molar mass of the compound multiplied by 100. Now see some examples. Percentage composition of water we have to find out. First of all, we will find out the molar mass of water, and as we know, this is 2. Number of atoms of hydrogen multiplied by 1.0, this is the atomic mass of hydrogen, plus 16, this is the atomic mass of oxygen, and this will come 18 gram. This is the molar mass of water. Then we can find out the mass percent of hydrogen. This is equal to mass of the hydrogen atom in the compound divided by molar mass of the water multiplied by 100. Put the value. This is 2. Again, 2 is the number of atoms of hydrogen multiplied by 1.0, which is the atomic mass of hydrogen. We can say 2 into 1, that is 2. This is the mass of hydrogen in water divided by molar mass of water multiplied by 100, and this will come 11.11%. Mass percent of oxygen. Mass of the oxygen in the compound divided by molar mass of the water, and mass of the oxygen in compound is 16 gram divided by molar mass of water multiplied by 100, and this will come 88.89%. This mass percentage of oxygen in this case you can also find out by using this, that is, out of 100, if you subtract 11.11, you will get this is again 88.89. This is the mass percent. Actually, sum of the mass percent of all the elements present in a compound will be nearly equal to 100. That's why if only two elements are there, then if you know the mass percent of the one element, mass percent of the another element can be find out from this. See one more example. What is the percentage of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen in ethanol? First of all, molecular formula of ethanol. This is C2H5OH. Again, molar mass of ethanol. Two atoms of carbon multiplied by atomic mass of carbon, plus there is a 6 atom of hydrogen. How this 6? 5 atoms are these and 1 atom is this. In this way, atoms of hydrogen are 6 multiplied by atomic mass of hydrogen plus atomic mass of oxygen, and this will come 46 gram. Okay, then we can find out mass percent of carbon. This is 24. How this 24? This is 12 multiplied by 2, 24 divided by 46 multiplied by 100, and this is 52.17%. The same way, mass percent of hydrogen, that is mass of hydrogen, that will 6 divided by 46 multiplied by 100, and this will 13.04%. mass percent of oxygen, this is 16 divided by 46 multiplied by 100, and this will come 34.78%. then how can we verify that whatever the result we obtain, it is correct? Add these mass percentages. Okay, it will come nearly equal to 100. Okay, straight. Next, empirical formula and molecular formula. An empirical formula represents the simplest whole number ratio of various atoms present in a compound, whereas the molecular formula shows the exact number of different types of atoms present in a molecule of a compound. see some examples. If we come to formula of ethane, this is C2H6. This is the molecular formula. Two atoms of hydrogen and two atoms of carbon and six atoms of hydrogen present in the ethane. But if you find out the simplest ratio of carbon and hydrogen, number of atoms, ratio of the number of atoms of carbon and hydrogen, it will come. This is CH3. 1:3. That is 1 is carbon and 3 is hydrogen. That's why its empirical formula is CH3. The same way, ethene molecular formula is C2H4, empirical formula is CH2. Benzene molecular formula is C6H6, empirical formula is CH. Glucose C6H12O6. This is the molecular formula and its empirical formula is CH2O. Hydrogen peroxide molecular formula is H2O2, empirical formula is HO. Water, for this the molecular formula and empirical formula both are same, because exact number of atoms of hydrogen and oxygen in water is 2:1, and their simplest ratio is also 2:1. That's why both are same. If the mass percent of various elements present in a compound is known, its empirical formula can be determined. Okay, and molecular formula can further be obtained if the molar mass is known. Now let us see some examples. A compound contains 4.07% hydrogen, 24.27% carbon and 71.65% chlorine. Its molar mass is 98.96 gram. What are its empirical and molecular formulas? Okay, make such type of table. First we write the name of element, carbon, hydrogen and chlorine. Mass percent, this is given. This is for carbon, this is for hydrogen and this is for chlorine. And their molar mass, for carbon this is 12, for hydrogen this is 1 and for chlorine this is 35.5. We are using only magnitude. Okay, that's why it is not necessary to write 12 gram per mole or 35.5 gram per mole. We are only using the magnitude. Then first we will find out the number of moles. N is equal to mass in gram divided by molar mass. And this mass percentage, okay, this is 24.27 divided by 12, this will 2.02. In the same way, 4.07, this is the mass percentage of hydrogen, divided by 1 atomic mass or molar mass. In magnitude, both are same. This is 4.07, that is for chlorine. Mass percentage is 71.65 and divided by molar mass is 35.5 and this will equal to 2.02. Now we will find out the relative number of moles. Now student, be careful. Now among these number of moles, which one is smallest value? Is that clear? Which one is smallest value? From that value, we divide all these number of moles. We can say this is 2.02, this is 4.07, this is 2.02. Which is the smallest? 2.02. That's why this 2.02 is divided by 2.02. This will be equal to 1. This is 4.07 is divided by 2.02. We will get 2. And again 2.02 is divided by 2.02. We will get 1. Okay. And their whole number ratio is 1, 2 and 1. If these are in the fractions, then we have to multiply it by some integer to get the whole number ratio. Is that clear? Then from this whole number ratio of these moles, we can find out the empirical formula. That is, there is 1 atom of carbon, 2 atom of hydrogen and 1 atom of chlorine. That's why its empirical formula is CH2Cl. And from this formula, we can calculate its empirical formula mass. Okay, same way like we are calculating molecular mass or formula unit mass. This is 12 plus 2 into 1 plus 35.5 and this will equal to 49.5. This is the empirical formula. Then how can we find out the molecular formula? Molecular formula is related with the empirical formula by this. Molecular formula is equal to empirical formula into N. Now what is this N? N is the molecular mass or a molar mass. Remember student, don't be confused. Simply we are using the magnitude. That's why you can put either molar mass or molecular mass. And this is divided by empirical formula mass. And this is given 98.96. And this we have calculated and this will be equal to 2. That's why when this empirical formula, that is each atom of empirical formula is multiplied by 2, then we will get the molecular formula of the compound, that is C2H4Cl2. Clear, student? See one more example. Determine the empirical formula of an oxide of iron, which has 69.9% iron and 30.1% oxygen by mass. Again, make the table. Element is iron and oxygen. Mass percentage are given, 69.9% and 30.1%. Molar mass we have to know. Okay, otherwise it will be provided in the question, or you can see in the table of molar mass. 55.8 for iron and for oxygen, this is 16. We can find out the number of moles by dividing mass percentage. Okay, this is 69.9 mass percentage of iron divided by molar mass of iron, 55.8, and this will be 1.25. Again, this is 30.1 divided by 16, this will come 1.88. Now again, from these two values, which one is least? 1.25 is the least. That's why 1.25 is divided by 1.25, we will get 1, and this is 1.88 is again divided by 1.25, and this will be equal to 1.5. Then what is the nearest whole number ratio of this 1 and 1.5? Simply, when we multiply this by 2, okay, then this will be equal to 3. When we multiplying 2, we are getting 3 in the same way. This 1 is also multiplied by 2, and we will get this is 2. Simplest whole number ratio is 2 and 3. That's why its empirical formula is Fe2O3. I am sure that you have understood how can we calculate the percentage composition of a compound, and how can we calculate the empirical formula and molecular formula if mass percentage are given to us. Thank you, student. Subscribe my channel to get the new videos. Thank you.